If Lord Geidt had wanted to be seen to resign over Partygate, he had plenty of opportunities to do it over the last 6 months. The reason why he didn't, well, I suppose that's open to interpretation. However, the reason that he gave for resigning is, he says, the Prime Minister asked him to advise over a matter that the Prime Minister knew would breach the ministerial code. The former ethics advisor of the Prime Minister says that knowingly breaching the ministerial code is a step too far, is why he is resigning over this issue. However, from Downing Street's side of things, that's not at all what they were asking. Downing Street say they were asking Lord Geidt whether or not an action to protect what we understand to be the British steel industry would be in breach of the ministerial code. Now, there's an argument that says certain actions to protect the British steel industry may be in contravention of one or two lines of WTO rules set by the World Trade Organization, i.e. international law. Now, Downing Street say they were simply asking Lord Geidt whether or not this action would be in contravention of that law, and indeed, if that were the case, would it breach the ministerial code. It's very odd that Lord Geidt has sort of picked this issue as the one he will resign over, because as far as I understand it, the conversation over this particular trade measure took place last week. Indeed, many days before, Lord Geidt and the Prime Minister Boris Johnson had a conversation where Lord Geidt said on Monday in private to the Prime Minister that he would continue in his role through until the end of the year. So if Lord Geidt had had this ask of him, had been asked to adjudicate over a measure to protect British steel, and then several days later said, yes, I'll remain in your post, and then several days after that say, actually, I'm resigning, that raises some eyebrows. And what happened in between? Well, on Tuesday, Lord Geidt appeared before the PACAC Committee, the Constitutional Affairs Committee of the House of Commons, and had a bit of a rough ride there with members of Parliament from all sides of the House, sort of asking him the point of his job, asking him over various decisions. He looked visibly uncomfortable in that committee hearing, and maybe people are thinking that actually, maybe it was that appearance before that select committee, raking over various decisions, raking over not least Partygate, and indeed his multiple threats to resign as briefed out to the press over several months. Perhaps it's that actually pushed him over the line.